Hello everyone and welcome to Lindy's Gang YouTube channel, or mine, depending on where are you watching this video. And today I have for you a special project and a special technique. I decided for this post to experiment a little, and I'm gonna be applying, or replacing rather, alcohol inks with Lindy's sprays and powders. And you'll see what the beautiful effects you can achieve that way also. Not everybody has alcohol inks, not everybody is feeling comfortable with using them. So if you have Lindy's and some UPO paper and alcohol, it has to be a 90 degrees alcohol, then you can really create some magic. As I was showing just before, I prepared everything. I prepared few flat Fabio sprays and few Starburst sprays and one magical shaker. And as always, the full list of products you'll find on Lindy's blog, on my blog, and in the description box below. So what I'm doing here, I'm just basically spraying the Lindy's sprays onto the UPO paper. And the yellow one I decided to spray, splatter, to make a splatter with it. And I'm dabbing away excess of the color with a tissue. And in a small mini mister, I think it's called, I have alcohol ink, and now I'm spraying the alcohol ink onto the page. And you can see the colors move a lot. They get a little brighter, but that's not a problem. I'll add some more colors and you'll see what's happening. And they are small blackish pools also, which happens on the page. And I'm dabbing them delicately away with a tissue, because I don't really care for too much black color on this project. So I will be repeating the process a few times. Now I'm deciding to add some green, that's a Lucius Lime Flat Fabio. And again, spraying with alcohol. I really, really love the effect it's giving. And okay, you feel maybe that the paints are disappearing, but you'll see at the end that this is not really a case. They are just moving like crazy all over the page, and I was fascinated by the process. So now you've seen me splattering, or sprinkling rather, Ocean Breeze Blue Magical on the page with a brush, and again spraying alcohol on it. And then I'm using Oktoberfest Orange, that's a magical shaker. And again, spraying alcohol. With the shakers or magicals, the powder is not completely diluted with the alcohol, so it gives extra texture, the powder stays, and it looks really lovely. And after drying it all, look what's happening. I am adding a little bit again of alcohol ink. And actually I've noticed that it reacts only in the places when the paint is still not totally dry, but that's fine, still give me some extra beautiful colors. And look at that, you'll see on the close-ups that the powders are not diluted completely, and that they are giving this extra texture. Now even here you can see it. And then a second ago there was my little helper. I was working actually on this project with my daughter. Be careful, because the paint is actually sticking to your finger. And I got a few traces of my fingers on the paper. But that's not a problem. It actually gave me another extra texture. So I'm fine with that. And at the end, after adding all the embellishments you want, you can spray it with a sealer, or even with a hairspray, and that will preserve the colors. So I cut the paper, even though it was really hard for me to do because the paper was beautiful, but it makes perfect for ATC cards. And I added the base for it with a black paper. And this is again my daughter helping me. And now you can see I use some, I was doing some trials before, and I cut the small circles with a circle punch to just show you different colors I achieved with the alcohol inks and Lindy's. And now I'm gonna be adding some delicate stamping, as I really, really don't want to cover completely the beautiful background. And I'm using archival ink, which is permanent, and all and create stamp number 74. And I'm stamping on the craft mat or craft foam, like that the image is much clearer. And I will be alternating the stamp on the ATC cards because it's quite a large stamp and I love every single part of it. And I will come back to you soon. So the next part is to add embellishments. So I use industrial die cuts, and as the focal points, I use the die cuts from the AB Studio papers created by Agava Raniak. They're vintage elements and Be Gentle, and you can cut the pieces out of it. And I started adhering the elements to the ATC cards, either with a tacky glue or for a more texture with a 3D foam tape. Also adding some 3D powder from 13 Arts, which to me looks like mica flakes in a black color, and some brats also for the metal look. And as you can see, I tried to do my focal point in one particular place. I didn't want to go all over the card because I really do like the background. And simply didn't want to cover it up. I could have done some stenciling or some other things, but I really cared for the background too much to put something on it. And I will be adding some white splatter with this time acrylic paint. And I choose acrylic paint because it stays well on the paper and it does not mix with the colors underneath. And to finish the cards off, I will add some word stickers from Smalltalk by Tim Holtz. And somehow my video got cut at the last moment when I was adding the stickers. But the first card was done, so you can see how I was doing it. I was also inking the edges of the stickers. That's it. My project is done. I hope you like this tutorial and I hope I gave you some ideas. And I wish you all a happy day and good crafting. See you. Bye.